Happy holidays, Merry Christmas, especially if you have electricity, if you have the internet, you're doing a lot better than a lot of people. A lot of people in Tennessee experienced some power outages, some rolling blackouts. There was various situations where a lot of people lost services in Tennessee. There was a big pileup, 100 plus vehicle pileup on I-75 in Ohio. The temperature was just incredibly low. It's setting records for the cold here in America, in the various parts of America. You can call it whatever you want. I just call it a reminder of how cold it can get. I've been living in Kentucky for the last 8 years. I forgot how cold things can get. I used to live in Michigan, of course. And man, I came outside yesterday and it wasn't just a cold. I had to go and get some new gloves. The gloves that really helped me for that type of weather. It was just, you know, I went outside, I opened up the door, I tried to get the door open. It's so cold, the door wouldn't even open up. So I was fortunate enough to get one door open. Then I turned the vehicle on, then I walked, and I noticed, there's low tire pressure on the left passenger, rear, whatever. So I had to walk outside the vehicle, get the air compressor, connect it to the battery and get that going and put some air in that tire. Cause it just bugs me to drive around with a tire with low pressure. It's just something I just don't like. I just can't stand it. Anyway, trying to pry up every single door, you know? And then when I got on the road, the light came on for like one of the doors being open when it really wasn't, probably cause I was prying it open. And anyway, really cold weather all across the nation. Well, especially in the Midwest and in the northern area, but the South is experiencing a lot of cold as well. And speaking of that cold, is this a really good reminder that it makes sense to have some preparations for some type of emergency heat. This is a propane heater, has some safety features where if it tips over, it automatically shuts off. This is something, they said it's, you can put it on low for the bathroom and the bedroom, and high, maybe even for the, that's interesting, even for the bedroom. But anyway, this is a propane heater. The big one works really, really well. This one I haven't really tried that much, but I've had the Big Buddy heater, so that's really good for like bigger rooms or stuff like that. So if you do have a situation where you don't have heat in your home, you can use something like this to heat up at least one room in your home. And these things run off of propane, it's an option. You can also use propane for heaters, for stoves, for portable stoves. This one comes with with an adapter, right? Something to keep in mind. So you want to have some type of preparations for emergencies because you just never really know. And this weather situation should be a really good reminder. And it makes sense to prepare. Now, other things going on. Going back to the weather, I think one of these companies, Con Edison, is asking 1.1 million natural gas and 3.5 million electric and steam customers in New York. The New York metro region to conserve energy due to this really cold weather. And I just wish people the best. This is one of the reasons why I always talk about emergency preparation. You want to be prepared for emergencies. But anyway, something I just want to mention, Ukraine. Yeah, situation in Ukraine. The Russians are obviously building up more and more forces in Belarus. There's a big question as to what are they going to do? What's going to be their mission? Are they going to sweep down into Western Ukraine and cut off the Ukrainian military from resources coming out of Poland, from NATO? Is that going to be their mission? Is that going to be a move they're going to make? Are they going to try to link up with are they going to make that big separation? That's a big question, because there's a significant amount of Russian soldiers, Russian resources in Belarus right now. I don't know if the Belarusian military is going to play a part in what's going to happen next. But it's the writing seems to be on the wall. The Russian ambassador to the U.S. said, quote, the risk of conflict between the two countries is high. What type of conflict? He went on to say, there's another quote, and this is really concerning. This is what you don't want to see between the U.S. and Russia. I'm reading this quote. There is practically no communication, end quote. Definitely not what you want to see. Russian ambassador to the U.S., and this is the source is War News 24/7. This is a Greek website, so it's not Russian propaganda or whatever. Russian ambassador to the U.S. has compared the state of U.S.-Russia relations to the Ice Age and said the risk of conflict between the two countries is high. What type of conflict? What type of conflict? I will say this. When we get to the point where Russia or the U.S. ends diplomatic relations, that's basically, to me, that's a sign that war is imminent. And when something like that happens, you don't want to read stuff like this. This is not what you really want to read. Meanwhile, Zelensky, leader of Ukraine, president of Ukraine, is working on a 10-point peace plan. I'm sure it's not going to be practical. It's not going to be something that the Russians are going to possibly accept. He's going to continue with this until it's to the country's to Ukraine is absolutely devastated. It's tragic what's happening over there. But anyway, the Russians are saying that the U.S. Patriot missile system is inadequate. Well, it's outdated or whatever. Well, we'll see. We shall see about that. Germany, they're considering sending more Patriot missiles to Ukraine to counter Russian attacks. It's pretty obvious what's going to happen next. I just hope, at least as far as the conflict in Ukraine, the Russians are definitely in a position to potentially they're going to probably annihilate opposition in that country. And the Ukrainian military, that's what it looks like. Again, I'm not a military expert, but that's what it looks like to me. The mobilization, all the stuff. They're sending their T-90 tanks and all this other stuff. They're finally sending in their really modern stuff, not just the Soviet era stuff. The Russians are starting to send in their better stuff in now. As part of this mobilization, I'm glad we have peace in America this Christmas. There's a lot to complain about, but there's still some good things going on. Peace. You know, so some people may not have power, but we do have peace in America right now. I'm thankful for that. And I'm thankful for all you guys supporting me, watching my videos, giving me a thumbs up, liking my videos. I really appreciate that. I appreciate your advice, your kind words, even your critiques. You know, it's all welcome here on this channel. So I just want to share that with you before this year ends. Hopefully 2023 will be a better year for a lot of people. I don't have that very high expectations of 2023, but anyway, I'm enjoying peace. I'm using my Legion laptop, this gaming laptop, to play Civilization 6. It's been a long time since I played Civilization. Just enjoying that. What else? I'm watching Jack Ryan on Amazon. It's a lot of, I like those type of shows. Jack Ryan and Reacher and what was it? The Terminal List. Those type of action shows. I also like romantic comedies too. I'm into that as well. So I'm pretty versatile when it comes to those type of programs. Although, anyway. So that's what I'm looking at right now. Those are some things I'm doing, just enjoying this weekend. I hope you guys have a chance to spend some time with your family. I didn't get a chance to make it up to Michigan. The weather just seems pretty sketchy to me. I don't like to travel a lot in the winter, especially up north in Michigan. But yeah, I'm going to try to get up there again sometime soon in the next month or so, if the weather permits. I know it's a lame excuse, but anyway. All right, guys. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. I hope you are, once again, taking this whole prepping thing seriously with emergency heat. Something like that. Some type of plan in case the power goes out. Some people are complaining about the lack of infrastructure in various parts of the country. And that's something we can deal with some other time. But on an individual level, this is something that you could do right here, right now. Something you work on right now. So there you guys go. All right, bye.